We have just had a lunch with Kværner and Karl Løken as the CEO. You have held a presentation, and you now see a slight improvement in the market. You're talking about an opportunity line of 30 billion-50 billion annually. Could you say where you see this growth?
We have pinpointed out some growth segments within Kværner, where we see some large opportunities going forward. We also see some opportunities regarding international oil and gas projects, where we already are. We have delivered a lot of projects to the Norwegian Continental Shelf. Actually, that's where we see the growth potential. Summing up to an average to around 30 billion-50 billion Norwegian kroner as an addressable market for Kværner every year.
If you look at the historical margins, you have delivered since 2011 around 6% EBITDA margin. If you look at the last three, four years, that has increased to 8%. For an investor, how should we think about the margins going forward?
I think you have to look upon all the years that Kværner has been since Kværner was established in 2011. I think looking at the three years we now have behind us, where we had a very good margin, that's related to how the project portfolio mix has been in that period. In addition, how Kværner has been operated as a company has been very healthy through that period, and we have increased our competitiveness during that period as well. But in general, I would say that you have to look upon the entire period when we are talking about the margin of Kværner.
Okay. If you look at your growth target, it's quite ambitious. You're looking to grow your top line by roughly 30% from the current level to 10 billion Norwegian kroner. How will you be successful in delivering such growth?
We've said that we will grow to 10 billion in a period of 5 years. That we said last year, so that means within 2023. We see that we want to take an increased share of projects at the Norwegian Continental Shelf. We shall succeed in winning international project within the traditional segment, oil and gas, and we also want to win prospects within what we have now pinpointed as our growth segments.
I'm here with the CFO in Kværner, Idar. You have decided, and the board have decided to pay a dividend this year of 1 per share. How should investor think about the dividend strategy for Kværner going forward? Should them expect a regular dividend, or is this a extraordinary dividend you paid this year?
First of all, it's not an extraordinary dividend. What we have done, and that has been a clear priority for us over the last 3 years, is to build financial strength and make sure that we deliver on all of our projects in a predictable manner and with sound and good results. That I think we have demonstrated. We have also dealt with legacy projects and sold those, most of them. This have created a strong financial, let's say, capacity for us and a robustness that is important also when we are now competing for new contracts. In addition, as we have pointed out, it's also in a market like this, there could be strategic opportunities to develop the company further, and that our balance sheet is also providing the opportunity to take part in those type of possible further developments of the company. When it comes to the dividend, we will have our dividend policy intact as communicated before, and every half year. Next time will be after the second quarter of 2019. We will then announce what dividend could be at that point in time. The dividend policy remains the same.
You have promised that Kværner will continue delivering solid financial results. And I guess as long as you deliver solid financial results, you will be in a position to pay dividend to shareholders.
Absolutely. There is no reason to for us not to be able to pay dividends by continuing the good sort of track record that we have established, delivering strong financial results on our projects. And then there is room for both developing the company and also returning money to the shareholders.
Thank you and good luck in the future.